Amen.
So you're saying that there's a universal teleology even with small children, so I'll let you lay that case out real briefly.
Yeah, this is just something, as I've read various journal articles, that kind of universal across humanity is this idea that there's something beyond just the physical, that there's a God who's doing something, or there's a spiritual aspect out there. And to me, that is a difficult thing to understand if the physical creation is all there is. It seems to make more sense in a worldview where the physical is very important, but there's also a spiritual dimension that transcends the universe. And the fact that it's kind of universal across humanity seems to say that it's something inherent to humanity, that we have this capacity to think beyond the physical, which is unusual if we're just physical creatures.
Well, let me try to relay. I think this is Michael Shermer that said this. You may have heard this example, but you know, he said, for example, let's say you're an ancient human in the African forest and you see some leaves moving. So it's kind of normal to, or natural to say, like, well, there might be a lion in there. It's better to have a false negative, because if you think there might be a lion in there, then you go run off and save yourself. If you don't, you're going to get, you might be lunch. And so,
right.
And so, you know, whenever something happens, if you're sleeping at night and you're always wondering about being attacked at night, if you hear a strange sound, your first thought might be there's an intruder. And if you don't see anything, then maybe the next step is thinking, well, maybe there's invisible creatures. And then especially when you have dreams, you know, sometimes people dream about deceased people. So they think that might be evidence for, you know, ghosts. So, I mean, maybe there's good explanations for ghosts for that reason. And then God is basically just, you know, the ultimate ghost. They call him, the Holy Spirit's called the Holy Ghost. It's just, you know, an immaterial mind.
Yeah, I guess what my contention is that I agree that being able to see whether there's an animal that's attacking and being aware that there's a utility to that, but it doesn't follow, as I see it, that that you begin thinking about things that are non-physical, because for all, you know, if the physical is all there is, why are we having thoughts about stuff that doesn't actually exist? That just doesn't seem to make sense to me. And that seems to be something that is being borrowed from a Christian worldview where the physical is not all there is. It makes more sense for us to be thinking about things beyond the physical in a Christian worldview than it does in a worldview where the physical is all that exists.
Why is it such a big deal to think about things that don't exist? For example, you know, there's very elaborate stories about, you know, the Harry Potter series and Star Wars sagas, and some people know the stuff inside and out. It's like these characters are alive in their head, but it's all fiction.
I agree, but again, to all of that's going on in the context of humanity. And I would argue that humanity has that capacity to think beyond the physical because we're made in God's image. It's not clear to me why in a world where the physical is all there is.
Say that again, why
any
what?
Sort of thing start thinking about stuff that's not actually physical.
Can you say that last part again?
So in a world where the physical is all there is, which is, I'm assuming that's an accurate characterization of an atheist worldview.
I would prefer the word naturalist. Instead of materialist, say natural. Yeah, everything's natural.
Okay. So where the natural world is all there is, why is it that any organisms in that realm have the capacity to think about stuff that is beyond the natural world?
Because, I mean, we just have brains. Brains compute. We evolved brains because it's a survival thing. There's a very strong fight for survival. The person with the smarter brain is going to have a hand up.
Correct. But what's going on there in that argument, as I see it, is, you know, for the dog or the cat or the tiger or whatever to see things, there's a very physical reality of what they're, you know, there are cats and dogs and tigers and other things that are attacking. To go now and to say that there are these things that we can't see that are unphysical, that are outside the natural realm, that seems to be a change of categories there. And again, for humans, that makes perfect sense in a Christian worldview. It's not clear to me that that makes sense from a naturalist worldview.
Well, what about somebody who's, you know, in his room at night and they're a little bit scared because let's say they're kind of they're like a teenager and their parents are gone. They're all by themselves at night and they hear a sound, you know, and they check it out and it turns out it's nothing. But they actually were freaked out because they thought it was a burglar or a demon or something. So, you know, they thought there was something there and there wasn't. Maybe that's what God is. We think there's something there and there's not.
But why? I mean, and again, I would love to investigate this at some point in time to see. I don't think there's any evidence that dogs think of their past ancestors, or maybe there's ghosts out there, that seems to be a uniquely human phenomenon. And I agree that because we're made in God's image, we have that capacity. But what my question is if we're not, if there is no God and the physical world, the natural world is all there is, why are we having these thoughts about things that are completely unnatural or that are beyond the natural world? That I'm able to think about something that's beyond what actually exists.
Well, I mean, maybe it's just part of maturity. Like when you're a child, you could easily believe in Santa Claus and the Tooth Fairy, but when you get older, like at your age, it's impossible to believe in the Tooth Fairy, you know? And so maybe like, you know, the Neanderthals, they were saying, who caused the lightning? We know we see fire, we can maybe even start fire. So there's fire in the sky, obviously there must be a fire god. And who causes the earthquakes? Who causes the floods? You know, maybe it's just immaturity that you say it was magic and just an appeal to magic because they don't know the answers. And then we learn the answers in science. We learn about electricity. We learn about tectonic plates. Maybe it's just immature humans.
The only species we seem to have any evidence that has the capacity to think beyond the physical is humanity. And in my worldview of a Christian, that makes sense because we're made in God's image. It's still not clear to me why, if the natural world is all there is, why would there be organisms that can think about things beyond the natural world?
Okay. Ready for the next topic?
Yes. Yeah.